Is there anyone who scored more than 25 in the last quiz examination? Anyone
Only
scored
25.
more than 25? Only 25, I think. Roll number 13. Eh? What's your name?
Samya.
Okay. Anyone else more than 25? Or 25, okay. Anyone else got 25? Only one. So you are the topper. Out of 35 marks, 25 is not the maximum mark, but very unfortunate. Very unfortunate. Please let me know how many of you have searched in the internet for the answers. 13. Have you searched in the internet for any of the questions? Roll number 13. Have you searched in the internet for any of the questions?
No, sir.
There is nothing wrong. I don't mean that searching in the internet is something a wrong thing or you should never do that. Okay, I know that there is a possibility, then you are allowed to do. I felt that even if you do, there is nothing wrong for me. But how many of you have used the facility of the internet that is available? That's what I want to know. See, even though I say you should not use, you can use. So when you are there is a possibility, why I should restrict? You are allowed to use your internet also, no issue. Anyway, shall we proceed? But I'm not satisfied, okay? But I'm not satisfied. If you tell me that I should change in any way, I am ready to change. Okay? Anyway, so let us do some problems. Okay? Let us do some problems to see that to what extent that we have understood so far. Okay? So let me know if screen is visible or not.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So anyway, you need not note down this question, okay? Because I'll be sending this particular PDF. So only thing is just read the question yourself. And please let me know how we are going to proceed in solving this problem. That's all. Okay? Because writing again, you can write later on if you are interested, but right now it is consuming our time. Okay? So just read it. One of you can read loudly, and so that we'll proceed how we can attempt this question. Okay? So one of you can read loudly. Take the chance. Okay? Whenever a chance is given to you, please take the chance. One of you read loudly. See, reading also you have a problem. Very unfortunate. Are you students or not?
Consider an entire thing.
What is your roll number?
Eight, sir.
Only 8 is responding all the time. I think from the next time onwards, I can teach only to the 8. All others you can leave and you can sit in your house. Why you are coming? What is the problem in reading the question? I don't understand you people. Don't you know the English? Roll number 31 is there?
Yes, sir.
Read the question.
Consider entered silicon semiconductor at T is equals to 300 degree Kelvin, in which Na is equals to 10 power 16 by centimeter cube and Na is equals to 0. The intrinsic carrier concentration is assumed to be Ni is equals to 1.5 into 10 power 10 by centimeter cube. Determine the thermal equilibrium electron and hole concentration for a given doping concentration.
Very good. See, don't hesitate to come forward. Okay. See, when I attended one workshop at IIT Kanpur, okay, what happened is one English professor called anyone there, literally more than 2000 students were there. he called one of us to come on to the dais. He mentioned nothing. What we have to do, he has mentioned nothing. He just called one of the students to come on to the dais. Okay? Everyone thought that as it is a workshop, he may be asking some questions. Everyone afraid and no one is trying to come forward. Okay? When I came forward and went on to the dais, what he has done is he has clapped and he has appreciated just for coming forward and he has given 2000 rupees. It is not a matter of money. It is a matter of coming forward. What is there in that? What is going to happen? When no one else is coming forward, we have to take the chance of coming forward. What will happen? Is that he or she is going to hang you? No. And that too, we are professionals. We are learning the professional course. And we have to always come forward. Take the chances. Chances will never come to you as and when you wish. Chances are going to come rarely and you have to grab the chances. ఒక్కసారి క్వశ్చన్ చదవమంటే ఎవరికాడు ముందుకు వచ్చి చదవడానికి ట్రై చేయలేకపోతున్నాడు. వాట్ ఐ హ్యావ్ టు డూ ఈస్ నో, యూ రీడ్ ఐ హ్యావ్ టు టేక్ ది ఛాన్సెస్ చాయిసెస్ ఆఫ్ గివ్ టు హూమ్ ఐ హ్యావ్ టు గివ్ ది ఛాన్స్. బట్ అన్ఫార్చునేట్లీ నో వన్ ఈస్ కమింగ్ ఫార్వర్డ్. ఐ డోంట్ నో వాట్ ఈస్ సి ఇఫ్ ఐ పిన్ పాయింట్ దట్ ఈస్ ఓకే, ఎనీ వన్ క్యాన్ డూ దట్. నేను పర్టికులర్గా ఒక నంబర్ని పిలిస్తే చదవడం అనేది అది మ్యాటర్ కాదు. అంత 2000 మందిలో ఒక పర్టికులర్ పిన్ పాయింట్ చేసి నువ్వు రా అంటే ఎవరైనా వస్తాడు. నిన్ను పిలిస్తే రాకపోవడానికి మనకేమైనా అంత యారగెన్సీ మనకే ఉండదు కదా, పిలిచినా కూడా చెప్పకపోవడానికి. బట్ ఈ పిలవకుండా ఉన్నప్పుడు దట్ ఈస్ హౌ ఐ గివ్ పోజెస్, ఐ గివ్ ఛాన్సెస్ టు ది పీపుల్. ఓపెన్ హ్యాండెడ్లో మనం ముందుకు రావాలి. అంతేగాని మనల్ని పట్టుకొని పిలిస్తే ఎందుకు రాము? మన పేరు పట్టుకొని పిలిస్తే బయటికి రాము, వస్తాం కదా. సో అలా ఉండాలి ప్లీజ్. ఎప్పుడైనా జనరల్గా నేను ఓపెన్గా ఛాన్సెస్ ఇచ్చినప్పుడు ముందుకు రావడానికి ట్రై చేయండి. అలా వస్తేనే మన ఫ్యూచర్లో కొద్ది బ్రైట్నెస్ ఉంటుంది. లేకపోతే అలా నూతుల్లో కప్పలాగా అలా ఉండిపోవడమే, మనకు వచ్చి అనుకుంటాం ఏమి రాదు, మనకి స్టేజ్ ఫియర్ పోతుంది. మీరు కనీసం అందరి ముందు చదవడానికే ఇబ్బంది పెడితే ఇంకేముంటుందండి అసలు. సో ప్లీజ్ డోంట్ టేక్ మై వర్డ్స్ ఇన్ ఎ హర్స్ వే. మై ఇంటెన్షన్ ఈజ్ హౌ యూ హ్యావ్ టు బీ. ఓకే, అండ్ వన్ మోర్ థింగ్ ఈజ్ దిస్ స్లాష్ సెంటీమీటర్ క్యూబ్. ఓకే, ఈజ్ వాట్ ఈస్ ది యూనిట్ యూనిట్ ఫర్ యువర్ ఎండి, నంబర్ ఆఫ్ డోనార్ యాటమ్స్. ఓకే, కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ ఆఫ్ డోనార్ యాటమ్స్ యూనిట్ ఈస్ పర్ సెంటీమీటర్ క్యూబ్. ఓకే, ఆర్ సెంటీమీటర్ టు ది పవర్ ఆఫ్ -3. దిస్ ఈస్ ద యూనిట్. ఓకే, రైట్. క్యాన్ ఎనీవన్ టెల్ మీ హౌ డు వి ప్రొసీడ్? ఎన్ టైప్ సెమీకండక్టర్ ఈజ్ మెన్షన్డ్. టీ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 300 degrees కెల్విన్ ఈజ్ మెన్షన్డ్. ఎండి ఈజ్ గివెన్. ND is what? Donor atoms. How many donor atoms we have considered? 10 to the power of 16 we have added, assuming that all have been ionized and 10 to the power of 16 electrons have been produced by means of adding dopants. That is why we are calling N-type, because Na is made zero. Okay? Can I call this as a compensated semiconductor?
Yes, sir.
No. How I can call it as a compensated semiconductor? Because Na is zero, no? Na is zero, no? In compensated, both type of dopant atoms have to present, no? But here Na is zero, so can I call it as an N-type compensated semiconductor? No. Compensated semiconductor means both type of impurities need to be present. So here only Nd is mentioned, Na is mentioned to be zero. Zero means no, you have not added any acceptor atoms. That means what? It is not a compensated semiconductor. Okay, so remember that compensated semiconductor means both Nd and Na have to be present. Only one is present means that is your semiconductor depending upon whether Nd or Na. Okay, so it is an N-type silicon semiconductor. Nd is given, Na is zero. So intrinsic carrier concentration is assumed to be 1.5 into 10 to the power of 10 per centimeter cube. You are asked to determine thermal equilibrium electron and hole concentration for a given doping concentration. So, you are asked to find N0 and P0. How do you find?
Charge neutrality. Charge neutrality equation.
Yeah, we have already got an equation. Okay, we have already got an equation. Instead of using this equation, or you can take the charge neutrality equation, your mass action law, and you can plug in there and you can derive it, and still you will be getting with the help of this formula. Okay. So, we have got N0 is equal to Nd minus Na by 2 plus root over Nd minus Na by 2 whole square plus Ni square. Okay. So, is Nd is given? Yes, Nd is given. Na is 0. Okay. So, you can substitute all Nd, Ni, Na is 0. So, you will be getting some number N0. So, quickly tell me what is N0? Because I don't have answers. I have only questions. Okay. So quickly tell me what is n naught, or I can approximate. How do I approximate? If I consider my nd is much greater than ni, okay, I know that my n is given by nd itself. So I'll I don't do any calculations, but I can approximate as my n is n naught is equal to 10 to the power of 16 per centimeter cube. Why? Because it is clearly visible to me that my nd is much greater than ni. Ni is only 10 to the power of 10, whereas nd is 10 to the power of 16. So as nd is much greater than ni, I can confirm that my n naught is given by nd itself. Okay. So that is how I can quickly tell that my n naught is 10 to the power of 16 per centimeter cube. But you calculate using this formula and tell me what is that you will be getting.
0.22 into 10 to the power of 32.
No, 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 no. See, the approximate correct answer is 10 to the power of 16 only. Because it is clearly visible to me that nd is much greater than ni. If nd is much greater than ni, I can neglect ni. If I neglect ni, what is that n naught is approximately given by nd only. So that means I should get an answer even when you use this formula, approximately equal to 10 to the power of 16 only. No other answer is allowed. Use your calculators. Use your calculators.
10 to the power of 16.
Approximately 10 to the power of 16 only. Okay. So even if I use the formula or if I try to use my approximation, n d is much greater than n I. In either case, I will be getting my n naught as 10 to the power of 16 only. Okay. Right. If n naught is 10 to the power of 16, then what is p naught? If n naught is 10 to the power of 16, that means n naught is directly approximately given by nd itself. So what is p naught? How do you find minority carrier concentration if majority carrier concentration is known to you? Which law will
be mass action?
Mass action law. Mass action law will be useful for us in calculating one type of charge carriers if the other type of charge carriers are given to you. So as you have calculated majority charge carriers, minority charge carriers can be calculated using mass action law. What is mass action law is telling? N naught p naught is equal to ni square. Ni is already given. So p naught is equal to ni square by n naught. N naught is known to be nd. Nd is 10 to the power of 16. So what is p naught? P naught is ni square by n naught. Ni is 1.5 into 10 to the power of 10 whole square divided by 10 to the power of 16. So tell me what is the answer. What is p naught? N naught I have come to known as 10 to the power of 16, you said. So what is p naught?
2.25 into 10 to the power of 4.
Very good. 2.25 into 10 to the power of 4 per centimeter cube. Unit is very, very important. Okay. Unit is very, very important. If I go to a shop and if I ask that, give me 2 kgs milk, it will be very awkward. Okay. So there you can understand that what is the significance of unit. Unit is very, very important. People do neglect writing the units under each parameter. But you don't neglect that. Always try to take care of writing the unit. Okay? Right.
So, sir.
Yes.
Such a doubt, sir.
Chepandamma.
N-type semiconductor, sir.
Yes, yes.
Intrinsic carrier concentration, enna ante enti sir mari andulo?
No. See, how we are getting N-type silicon semiconductor? Only upon doping, no?
Sir.
Only upon doping with nd, where you have considered nd as 10 to the power of 16. Okay, but before you start doping, how many charge carriers are there and what are there?
Okay, sir.
Before you start doping, it is an intrinsic semiconductor. In an intrinsic semiconductor, there are some carriers. What carriers are there? As many number of electrons are there, that many number of holes are there, and that is equal to some number, and that number is 1.5 into 10 to the power of 10 per centimeter cube. And how do I get this number for a given temperature, for a given material? I have a formula. A naught into T power 3 by 2 into E power minus Eg by KT. Right? So I can easily calculate intrinsic carrier concentration. But what is intrinsic carrier concentration? You don't do anything. You don't do anything means what? You don't dope with any of the dopants. Then there will be some number of carriers available. And that carriers is what is that you are calling it as intrinsic carrier concentration. Okay, see you said the definition of doping as adding impurities to your intrinsic semiconductor. Intrinsic semiconductor is already having the carrier concentration. And how you are telling that it is an n-type semiconductor, you are considering your n-naught greater than ni. Okay, ni is always there. Ni is always there. Yes or no? you take any material. Is Ni is there or not? Ni is there. So some carriers are already available, but those are not sufficient for your purpose. So you are increasing the carrier concentration. And how you are doing? By means of doping. Okay.
Okay, sir. Sir, ND ante number of donor atoms, sir.
Yes, yes. ND means number of donor atoms. Okay. N-type semiconductor means how do we get N-type semiconductor? By adding donor atoms, by adding pentavalent impurity atoms. So how many you have considered? Okay. That is given as 10 to the power of 16 per centimeter cube. Okay.
ND lone pentavalent, trivalent, rendu untaya, sir.
Leer, nana. ND means 100% only pentavalent impurity atoms. Na means okay. Trivalent impurity atom. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Na means trivalent impurity atoms. Nd means pentavalent impurity atoms. Nd is equal to 10 to the power of 16 means 10 to the power of 16 phosphorus atoms. Me teesukunnara ani ardham. Okay.
Okay.
Na okay. 0 ante enti acceptor atoms emi intrinsic semiconductor ki add cheyaledu. So only pentavalent impurity atoms letha only phosphorus atoms add chesthe danni manu n type silicon semiconductor antam. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay. So I got the. You have understood this problem, right? Okay, Namma. Shall we go ahead?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. So now look at another problem. Consider a P-type compensated silicon semiconductor. What do you mean by compensated? You can expect both Na and Nd. Okay. Compensated means we will be finding in that semiconductor not only one type of dopants but also both the types of dopants. One is donor atoms, another is acceptor atoms. Okay, right. In which Na is given as 10 to the power of 16 per centimeter cube, Nd is given as 3 into 10 to the power of 15 per centimeter cube. So meaning what? Na is equal to 10 to the power of 16 means what you have considered? Na means acceptor atoms. So how many acceptor atoms you are adding to your semiconductor? How many 10 to the power of 16 acceptor atoms you have considered for adding, and how many donor atoms you have considered?
3 into 10 to the power of 15
per centimeter cube donor atoms you have considered. So because both acceptor atoms and donor atoms you have added in your semiconductor, intrinsic semiconductor, so you are calling it as compensated semiconductor. And that too, how I am able to call it as a p-type compensated semiconductor?
Nd less than Na.
In a p-type, Na is greater than Nd. Okay, so p-type means what? Acceptor atoms have to be more, though donor atoms are present. Okay, so here you could see that Na is 10 to the power of 16 and Nd is 3 into 10 to the power of 15. So naturally, Na is greater than Nd. So I can call it as p-type compensated semiconductor. Okay, intrinsic concentration is same is given as 1.5 into 10 to the power of 10. Again, we were asked to find equilibrium electron and hole concentration for a given doping concentration. Okay, so because both the dopants are being given, which formula will be helping me? Because it is a p-type compensated semiconductor, which formula will be helping? P naught is equal to, okay, Na minus Nd by 2 plus root over Na minus Nd by 2 whole square plus Ni square. Okay. Right. Is Nd given? Yes, Nd is given. Is Na is given? Yes, Na is given. Is Ni is given? Ni is given. So it is a matter of substitution of all the things that are given in your question. That's all. Very simple. So tell me, what is the answer for P naught?
7 into 10 power 15
per centimeter cube. Okay, don't forget to mention unit. Students, 99% students neglect the unit. Please don't forget. Okay. Then if P naught is given as 7 into 10 to the power of 15 per centimeter cube, then what is N naught? Minority charge carriers. I can find out using my mass action law. What is my mass action law? N naught into P naught is equal to Ni square. So that N naught is given by Ni square by P naught. Ni is given. P naught you have calculated. So what is N naught? So what is N naught? N naught is Ni square by P naught.
0.25 into 10 power 5, sir.
How much?
2.25 into 10 power
5. Everyone got same answer. If all of you get same answer, then it is right. If some of you are getting some other answer, then we have to verify. Please let me know whether everyone has got. What is the answer? 1.5 into 10 to the power of 10 whole square divided by how much you told? 7 into 10 to the power of 15. So what is the answer you got? If every one of you gets 3.21 into 10 to the power of 4 per centimeter cube. Okay. So I hope every one of you have got the same answer, right?
Yes.
Okay. So these are very simple. Okay. These are very simple. It is a matter of substitution in the formula. But the thing is, you have understood the concept of how I can get an n-type semiconductor, what I have to do to the intrinsic semiconductor so that I'll be getting n-type, what I have to do to the intrinsic semiconductor so that I'll be getting a p-type semiconductor. Okay. Compensated semiconductor means what? No one is going to learn compensated semiconductor. Okay. You can ask your next section friends, what is a compensated semiconductor? No one knows. Okay. Got my point? So, because no one studies this compensated semiconductor, but it is an essential. Everyone learns PN junction diode, but no one knows what is compensated semiconductor. Okay. Right. Is that fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then let us go for this problem. Consider a silicon semiconductor at 300 degrees Kelvin in which Na is equal to 2.5 into 10 to the power of 13 per centimeter cube. The intrinsic carrier concentration is assumed to be Ni is equal to 1.5 into 10 to the power of 10 per centimeter cube. What you are asked is, you tell me whether this material is N-type or P-type. Okay, and also calculate N0 and P0. N0 is representing what?
Electron concentration,
but don't forget to mention under thermal equilibrium. N naught means electron concentration under thermal equilibrium. P naught means electron hole concentration under thermal equilibrium. Okay, please, how do we differentiate N and N naught means? N naught means thermal equilibrium, electron concentration. Okay, when you apply no external excitation, you have not applied electric field, no current. Okay. But when you apply electric field, there is a change in the thermal equilibrium electron concentration, and that you are representing it as N. Okay. So have the differentiation between N and N naught. Okay. Have the differentiation between P and P naught. Okay. This naught is commonly used to represent thermal equilibrium concentration. Okay. And you have understood that thermal equilibrium means there should not be any external excitation to your semiconductor. Okay. And before we proceed, I have one more question, that what is the difference between ND and N or N0? What is the difference between ND and N0?
ND is number of donors.
ND is number of donor atoms and N is number of electrons. Okay. Both need not be equal. Please do understand. Both need not be equal. When they can be equal? Only when ND is much greater than NI. Then only they are equal. What are equal? N is equal to ND is equal. Okay? Right. So, can anyone tell me whether it is N-type semiconductor or P-type semiconductor?
P-type.
P-type. Tell me your reason. Why do you think that it is P-type?
Only acceptor atoms are there, sir.
More number of acceptor atoms are there.
Sir, ND not given, no, sir.
ND is not given, no? ND is not given, only Na is given, okay? Only Na is given. So, if I need to tell whether it is a P-type semiconductor or N-type semiconductor, okay? Either I should know whether ND is there or not, okay? Either I should know whether ND is there or not. Okay, so suppose if N D is not given in the question, okay, you can assume that N D is not there, because not given, no? Got my point? How we have to analyze the problem, okay? How we have to take the decisions, okay? So you yourself is the boss to take the decision if the data is not given in the question, okay? You can clearly mention there, okay? Assumption, N D is zero. Why N D is zero? It is not given. If it is not given, I'll take one number, you take another number, some other one take another number. Why all those ambiguity? But what is the best approximation when nothing is given? N is zero. Okay? And that is why it is being asked that whether it is N-type or P-type. If N is given, And what is the meaning in asking you that whether it is an n-type or p-type? Yes or no? If n is already given, and what is the meaning in asking you that? Tell me whether it is n-type or p-type. I can simply compare my n-a and n-d, and I'll immediately tell whether it is n-type or p-type. If n-a is greater than n-d, then I'll say p-type. If n-d is greater than n-i, then I'll say n-type. Okay? When both are given, what is there? Now you are asked to take the choice, take the decision. Okay? Have the assumption yourself. How do you understand in determining whether it is n-type or p-type based on the given data? When nd is not given also, you can tell. But under what assumption? Okay, nd is 0. Okay, because not given, so it is 0. So, na, okay, shall I go ahead with ni, n-type or p-type? P-type. So, what is your reason now? Assuming that nd is 0, so can I confirm that it is p-type?
Yes, sir.
So how I can confirm that it is p-type? P-type means p-type means majority are holes, and holes are coming out of your na, and na is given to be 2.5 into 10 to the power of 13, and it is much greater than your ni, so naturally it is expected to be p-type. Okay, so that is how you have to take the decision before if it is there is an ambiguity whether it is n-type or p-type. Okay. So if it is a p-type, how do you find p naught? Which formula?
P naught
equal to na.
Equals to na, sir. P naught is equal to na because na is much greater than ni. Or you can use the formula with n is 0, na is given with some number, ni is given with some number. Then also you will be getting approximately p naught is equal to na only. Okay? P naught is equal to na only. Okay? Right. If p naught is known to you, what is p naught is? Let us assume approximately 2.5 into 10 to the power of 13. If p naught is known to you, then how do you find n naught? Ni square by p naught. Okay, p naught is known to you, so n naught is ni square by p naught. Very good. Okay, so can you tell me what is p naught one number? N naught, p naught is
9 into 10 power 6,
sir. N naught is 9 into 10 to the power of 6. Okay, so if every one of you gets same answer, then it is fine. Okay, so you have got p naught and you have got n naught. Fine. Okay, good. The next problem. Shall I move to next problem?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So look at here. Consider a silicon semiconductor at T is equal to 300 degrees Kelvin, in which hole concentration p naught is given as 2 into 10 power 5 per centimeter cube. The intrinsic carrier concentration is assumed to be Ni is equal to 1.5 into 10 to the power of 10 per centimeter cube. Tell me whether it is N-type semiconductor or P-type semiconductor.
P-type, sir.
How do you say it is P-type?
Hole concentration itcher, sir.
Hole concentration itcher, but for a P-type semiconductor, what is the condition?
N-type.
See, if you look at your Ni, okay, my Ni is 10 to the power of 10. If you look at your P-naught, it is 10 to the power of 5. Holes are less than your Ni. Then can I call it as a P-type? What is the P-type? P-type means it is a resultant after adding your acceptor impurity atoms. What is the purpose of adding acceptor impurity atoms? To make sure that your number of holes are greater than, which number particularly? Greater than the available intrinsic carrier concentration. There are already some number which is intrinsic carrier concentration. If you say that my number of holes are less than that Ni, then how do I say that my holes are more in my semiconductor? No, I cannot say. That means it is no more a P-type semiconductor. Okay? So, because your number of holes are less than Ni, okay, when we are learning our N-type and P-type, I told you that my P number of holes are much greater than Ni, intrinsic carrier concentration or the concentration of electrons. Only then I will call it as a P-type semiconductor. But here, my number of holes are less than my Ni. That means I can never call it as a P-type. It is not that P naught is being given, so it is P-type. No. Okay? P-type means you have to verify whether my number of holes, not even the acceptor atoms. Okay? Not even you have to consider the acceptor atoms. For deciding whether it is a P-type or N-type, consider your majority charge carriers. Okay, compared to your intrinsic carrier concentration and the minority carrier concentration. Suppose if I want to confirm a P-type, P number of holes have to be greater than the intrinsic carrier concentration as well as compared to your number of electrons in the semiconductor. Only then I'll call it as P-type semiconductor. Okay, so now I think you have understood, right?
Yes, sir.
yes or no?
Yes sir.
Okay, so have clarity, okay, have full fledged clarity in the concept, then you proceed for solving the problem. Okay, so now you have confirmed that it is an n type. Okay, if it is not a p type, then what it would have been? It is an n type. Okay, so if it is an n type, okay, how do I find n naught majority charge carriers? N naught is equal to, because p naught is already given, you are just allowed to find out n naught. So n naught is equal to ni square by p naught. My mass action law, ni is already given, so ni square I know, by p naught. P naught is already given, 2 into 10 power 5 per centimeter cube. So n naught is equal to how much? 1.125 into 10 power 15 per centimeter cube. So now you can understand, p naught is only 10 power 5, n naught when you got calculated, you have got 10 to the power 15. So now you just tell me once again, revisit whether it is n type or p type.
N-type, sir.
Okay, because the electrons are more than the p-type, so it is n-type. Okay, so you have calculated indirectly n-naught, p-naught. Of course, p-naught is already given. You have calculated only n-naught, and you have very cleverly understood that it is which type of material. Okay, you have not confused in saying that it is a p-type. You have you know when to decide whether it is p-type or n-type. Okay, right. Is this fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let us do this problem. Consider a silicon semiconductor at T is equal to 300 degrees Kelvin, in which electron concentration is N naught is equal to 4.5 into 10 power 4 per centimeter cube. Nd is equal to 5 into 10 to the power 15 per centimeter cube. Intrinsic carrier concentration is given as 1.5 into 10 to the power 10 per centimeter cube. And you are asked to find whether it is N type material or P type material. And you are asked to calculate N naught and P naught. And you are also asked to calculate what types and concentrations of impurity atoms exist in the material. It is very interesting, I think. Okay? It is very interesting. So, first tell me whether it is N-type or P-type?
P-type, sir.
Loudly.
P-type, sir.
P-type. What is your reasoning?
N-naught is very less than
N-naught. Very good. So N-naught, number of electron concentration. Don't look at the ND, okay? ND is different from N-naught, okay? N-naught is telling the number of electron concentration. ND is telling you have added that many number of donor atoms. Let it be, though you have added 5 into 10 to the power of 15 donor atoms, but out of which, let us assume that only 4.5 into 10 to the power of 4 atoms only have got ionized, have got donated the free electron to your crystal. Is it not? So it is not that how many number of donor atoms I have added all need to contribute. There is no guarantee. Okay? There is no guarantee, and it is not mandatory that all the donor atoms have to contribute the free electrons to your semiconductor. Okay? Okay. So until and otherwise I mention complete ionization, we may not assume that all the atoms are ionized. All atoms are not contributed free electrons to your crystal. There is a chance that some may not give the free electrons. That is why I have considered this problem. Okay, so as N naught is much less than your Ni, so I'll consider it as a p-type. So because it is a p-type, N naught is given means what is given to us, minority charge carrier concentration or majority charge carrier concentration?
Minority
charge carrier concentration is given to us. So if you know minority charge carrier concentration, can you find majority charge carrier concentration in a p-type? Yes. What is the majority charge carrier concentration?
Holes.
So what holes. What are the number of holes p naught is equal to?
5 into 10 to the power 15 per centimeter cube.
Okay, don't forget to mention units. Okay, so you may be using your mass action law, p naught is equal to ni square by n naught. So you will be getting with 5 into 10 to the power 15 per centimeter cube. Okay, fine, good. So literally you have calculated n naught is already given, so you have calculated p naught, so you have got your electron concentration and hole concentration. Okay, fine. What is the last one? What types and concentrations of impurity atoms exist in the material? What types and concentrations? What types
trivalent
and trivalent impurities? Is Nd is present? Nd is present, sir. And it is already given. Nd is present in your semiconductor and it is already given. How much is given?
5 into 10 to the power 15.
So what else that we need to calculate it is, how many number of acceptor atoms are there? okay, how do you calculate how many number of acceptor atoms are there?
N naught plus N.
How many number of acceptor atoms are there? For example, how do you calculate P naught? P naught is given by
Na minus ND.
Okay, P naught is given by Na minus ND. See, P naught, how much is the number you got P naught?
5 × 10⁻¹⁵.
Is it much greater than Ni or not?
Yes, sir.
So when P naught is much greater than Ni, okay, then what is my P naught is given by Na minus ND? Yes or no? So P naught is equal to Na minus ND. So P naught is known to you, ND is known to you. Can you calculate your Na? Yes, you can calculate your Na. Okay, so we will use P naught is equal to Na minus ND. See, you consider an compensated semiconductor. Is it not this semiconductor is a compensated semiconductor? We were asked to find Na also. That means, is it not it is a compensated semiconductor? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So in a compensated semiconductor, you have confirmed that it is a p-type. So in a p-type compensated semiconductor, how do you calculate hole concentration? It is given by Na minus ND, provided that Na minus ND is much greater than Ni. So as you got your ND is much greater than Ni, as you got your P naught much greater than Ni, so your Na minus ND is automatically much greater than Ni. Then your P naught is given by Na minus ND. Okay, so this is all applying our concept. Okay, this is all applying our concept and then coming to a conclusion that, okay, P naught is given by Na minus ND. Okay, from that formula, we have taken three statements. When Na minus ND is much greater than Ni, my P naught is given by Na minus ND. I think you might have, you have to revise what, when once the class is over, then automatically you will be getting an idea for the given question. So P naught is equal to Na minus ND. So what is Na is given by? How much?
10⁻⁙.
So definitely I can cross verify whether Na I got is greater than, is correct or not, because Na is greater than ND. Only then I'll say that my Na whatever I have got is correct. Otherwise, because you have told that it is P type, so for a P type Na is always greater than ND. So when once you got some number for Na, you can cross check with your ND. If it is greater than ND, then it is fine. Otherwise, you have to re-verify whether you did right or not. Okay. Understood so far? Is this fine? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we'll stop here. Okay, so we'll continue in the next class. Fine?